thanks for joining us for Sophie's Circuit, and I'm Sophie. Here with me today is Jenny and Andrew. Let's go ahead and get started with air jump rope. Stay light on your toes here. Keep your core engaged. And try and keep your arms down low and just work on flicking those wrists to get that jump rope around. We're about to switch to alternating leg kicks. A few more seconds here. All right, in two, one. We're gonna find our base, feet about shoulder width, reaching opposite arm to opposite leg. Here we wanna focus on feeling a stretch in our hamstring. That's gonna be the back of our leg. Keeping that core engaged, chest is open. Go four more here. And one. Switching to arm swing. So we're gonna come out and hug around our chest. Try and open up that chest as you come out and really reach around. Again, keep those feet planted and core engaged. How you guys feeling? Good. All right, now we're gonna switch to over the back arm swing here. Stretch out that tricep a little bit. Good. Let's go four more here. Then we're gonna switch to standing quad stretch. All right, so how you have one base leg, you're gonna grab one foot with that same arm, stretch out the front of your leg, your quad muscles, and release. We just wanna hold this for a few seconds. And alternate, good. Try and focus on stabilizing with that base leg, keeping that core tight and chest open. To get a little bit of a deeper stretch, you can squeeze your glutes to try and push through and open up your hip flexor as well. Two more here, and then we're gonna transition to standing cat-cow. Last one. Good. I'm gonna turn to the side so you guys can see what I'm doing. You're gonna place your hands on your quads, gentle bend in your knee. You're gonna pull that belly button into your spine, let your neck roll over, and then open up your chest and look up. Good, and round under, and open. Good, focus on your breathing here. Try and move with your breath. Exhale all of your air, and open. One more time. And open. All right, let's get back to center, and we're gonna go back to our air jump rope. So pick up your jump rope, and let's get started again. Try and pick up the tempo a little bit. So staying light on your toes. Try and keep those wrists down by your legs. Alternating leg kicks in a few more seconds. And this time I want you to focus on getting a little bit deeper into that stretch. In two, one, stop. Good. All right, remember opposite arm to opposite leg. And if you can't reach your toe, that's okay. Just try and reach as far as you can while maintaining the integrity of your core and not bending forward. Go four more here. Now we're gonna go back to arm swings. Opening up that chest, hugging around. Alternate which arm is on top. As you see, I switch each time I hug around, which arm I place on the top. That just allows you to feel the stretch equally on both sides. Good. Okay, and really open up that chest, picking up the tempo just a little bit here, getting that upper body warm. All right, we're gonna transition to those over the back arm swings in 2, 1. All right, go. Try and tap the back, stretch out your tricep. Four more. All right, and standing quad stretch again. We're gonna grab that foot, open up that hip, and alternate. And release. And release, good. All right, we're gonna finish off with a set of jumping jacks. You guys ready? All right, two more here. And last one. All right, let's go. Try and pick up the intensity here. Stay light on your toes. Get those arms up straight. Good, we're gonna pick up the tempo just a little bit. Stay with me. Almost there. You're done in 2, 1. All right, shake that out. You guys ready to get started? All right, let's do it. We're gonna do today some Tabata, which is going for a few seconds of exercise and then resting and alternating that. So we're gonna start with alternating side lunges. We're gonna step to this side first, step over, down, keep your toe, knee, and shoulder in a line, and then come back together, and then to the other side. All right, let's go. For this, it's very important that both of your toes are pointed straight and you're sitting back into your hips with the weight. If you need to have a little bit easier of a modification, just come up a little bit higher. And if you want to take it to the next level, really sit deep into that lunge. And here we want to make sure our chest is open and upright. Give me two more here. And we're gonna transition to plank with a shoulder tap. We're gonna come down to a high plank. If you need to, you can just hold this plank. That can be your modification. If not, we're gonna tap opposite shoulder with opposite hand. All right, and go. Try and focus on keeping your core tight, not letting your hips shift as you tap opposite arm to opposite shoulder. And again, if you need a modification, you can just hold the plank stationary. Woo, this one's tough. You guys doing all right? Stay with me. Almost done. Give me three more taps. Three. Woo, good. All right, we're gonna stand that back up. Shake it out. And the next exercise is what I'm gonna call Dynamic Warrior Three. So Warrior Three is a yoga pose where you have one base leg extending the other out and reaching forward. So what we're gonna do is just very controlled, alternate between our legs, that Warrior Three position. You guys ready? Mm-hmm. All right, let's go ahead and get started and go. So reach forward. If you need a modification for this one, you can keep that back foot planted and just reach forward with your upper body. Here I want you to focus on keeping your core tight and your torso parallel with the ground. And this one doesn't have to be fast. Just go at your own pace, very controlled. Give me two more here. Last one. Whew, good job. All right, we have all that again. I'll give you guys a second to grab some water. And we're gonna go ahead and get started with our alternating side lunges again. You guys ready?
Yes.
All right, we're gonna go this way first and go. Remember, sitting back, coming back to center. If you're at home and you have some dumbbells, you can hold one right here in front of you if you want a harder version of this exercise, add a little bit of weight. Just a little bit. Good. Give me four more here. Two and one. Nice job. Let's shake that out and get down for our plank with shoulder taps. Get those wrists in line with your shoulders and your core tight. And go. When you're doing these, you want to make it look like your both of your hands are planted. So you don't really want any part of your body except that arm to move. And again, if you need to take the modification, do so at any time. Let's go. Six more shoulder taps. Stay with me. And six. Woo! Nice work. All right. And let's shake that out and get ready for our dynamic warrior three. Having that one base leg, we're going to reach forward and extend. Good. Back to center. Try and think about your arms and feet are attached to a string that are just stretching your body out as you're coming into this position. And as you might notice, you can see my ankle shaking quite a bit. This is really good to develop your ankle stability. And that's okay, just as long as you try and focus on maintaining your balance. All right, give me one more here. And forward. Whew, good job. Let's take a sip of water. We're gonna go into our next circuit of exercises. The first one is gonna be a squatted side step. So we're gonna squat down, step, step, back, back. So it's gonna be two one way, two the other. You guys got that? Go ahead and get started. Down to our squatted position, and this way. Good. All right, now we're gonna try and pick up this tempo a little bit. Nice. So it's more of a shuffle now. We're just staying low, shuffling side to side. You need to increase the intensity, get a little bit lower with that shuffle. Try and stay on your toes here, keep that chest upright. Good. All right, give me two more. One more. All right, woo! That was tough, feel that in your legs. Let's shake that out. We're gonna go ahead and get started with a scarecrow pose and an isometric lunge. That's a lot of big words. I'll break it down for you. You're gonna lunge forward and hold this high lunge pose. Bring your arms out to 90 degree angles. We're gonna hinge forward at the hips, keeping our back straight, come back up to center, and then rotate over that front leg, back to center, and again. Go ahead and get started. For this one, you wanna make sure that your core is engaged, you're upright. Both of your feet are pointed straight and that weight is in your front heel. gonna go three more here. Then we're gonna switch to the other side. Last one. And switch. All right. Ready, go. You might notice that one side feels different than the other. And that's okay. You're just gonna have better balance on one side than the other. We wanna try and keep everything really engaged and focus on your stability here. Give me three more. One. And done. Woo! Good job. All right, shake that out. We're gonna get our legs get a little bit of a rest. We're gonna go into a high side plank. Okay, so coming down to the ground, you can have your feet side by side or stacked on top of each other. The side by side will be a little bit easier. All right, you guys ready?
Yep.
And go. You want to make sure that your shoulder and wrist are in a line. You can reach up, take that modification if you'd like. If you need to, if this is too much on your wrist, you can also come down to the low plank. So you guys can stay with me here. We'll go up to the high plank with Jenny and Andrew. All right, we only have about 10 more seconds here. That flew by. We're gonna switch to the other side. In two, one, switch. All right. Ready, and go. If you need to as well, and this is still too much, you could always drop that bottom leg and come to a modified side plank. But still focus on keeping your hips up, and you want both of your hips stacked on top of each other as well as your shoulders. All right, almost there. Hold this strong, try and really keep your hips up, core is engaged. Coming down in two, one, down. All right, good job. Grab a sip of water, and we're gonna repeat that circuit. You guys ready? We're gonna get started with that squatted side step, okay? Just like last time, let's squat down. One side, back, back. Good. You guys ready to pick up the pace again? All right, let's do it, and go. Try and really keep your hips back in a nice squatted position, chest upright. And make sure your knees don't go in front of your toes here. And keep those toes pointed straight, Andrew. Good job. All right, let's sit a little bit lower and go a little bit faster. Almost there. Stay light on those toes. All right, one more. Back and done. Woo, all right. Nice work. Have that heart rate up a little bit. We're gonna go right into that scarecrow with the isometric lunge. So lunge forward. Get that strong position, slight bend in the knees, arms up, and hinge forward. Good. Guys, we're looking great. Make sure that front knee does not push in front of that front toe. All right, give me three more here. Last one, and switch to the other side. All right, opposite leg forward, arms up. You guys with me?
Yep.
All right, let's go. Good. When you bend over, you wanna make sure that chest is open. That core stays tight and you're just hinging at the hips slightly. Almost there, three more. Last one. Woo, all right. Let's get right back into our side plank. You guys ready?
Yep.
All right, starting on one side. Again, take any of the modifications that you need. I'm gonna come up to high plank this time and go. You wanna make sure that shoulder is again in line with that wrist. And you can choose to stack your feet or move them side to side as a modification. All right, 10 more seconds here. Stay strong, make sure both of your hips are in a line and that your glutes are engaged. We're gonna switch in 2, 1, and switch. Let me go over to the other side. And up. This is a great exercise to work not only your core, but your glutes as well. So you wanna make sure your hips are up and in line with your body. Stay strong. You guys are with me? Yeah. All right. Almost there. Coming down in 3 and down. All right. Okay. Whew. Shake that off. Grab some water. This next round, we're going to have 3 exercises to go through. We're going to do them for a little bit shorter periods of time, but the tempo is gonna be increased just a little bit, okay?
Yep.
All right, the first exercise I'm gonna show you guys at home from the side is what we call an overhead squat. So it's just a normal squat where you're sitting back, hinging at the hips, knees and toes in a line, but our arms are actually gonna be up by your ears, squatting back, okay? Guys, ready? Go ahead and get started and go. So here, we want to try and keep our arms up by our ears. This is a great exercise for mobility, and it also forces us to keep our core more engaged. All right, we're almost done here. Let's try and pick up the tempo just a little bit. We're gonna switch to downward facing dog with a knee tuck in 2, 1. All right, bring those arms down. Get into downward dog. We're gonna go one leg at a time, reaching that leg up and tucking into your knee. So reach out and tucking in, up, in. 3 more here. Last one. All right, other side. Ready? Extend that leg and crunch in. Last one, we're gonna do a lying glute bridge. We're gonna come down. I'll show you guys from the side. You wanna get your feet pointed straight. Chest is gonna lie on the ground. Hands by your side. You're gonna hinge at the hips and bridge up so that your legs and hips are straight and come back down. All right, ready? Go. Going up. You really wanna focus on engaging your glutes here. And extending all the way up to the ceiling. Good. And it's okay to pause at the top. Really try and squeeze and feel that contraction. All right, almost there. Give me 3 more. 1, 2, and 3. All right, woo! Let's shake that off, stand up. Grab a sip of water. You guys are doing great. All right, we're gonna get back to our overhead squats. Feet about shoulder width apart, arms up by your ears, hinging at the hips and sitting back. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Go. So sit down and up. We're gonna keep the intensity up on these sets, so our tempo is gonna be a little bit faster. If you're at home and you take it a little bit slower, that's totally all right. Just go at your own pace. The most important thing is the integrity of your form here. You can try and widen your stance a little bit, Andrew. That might help you get down in your squat a little bit more. Make sure you're sitting back and your knees don't go over your toes. All right, we're gonna transition to the downward dog in 2, 1, go. All right, plant those wrists in line with the shoulders, push back, extend one leg, and tuck in. Good. Two more. Last one. And switch. Extend and tuck in. One more. Good. All right. Come down for our glute bridges. You guys ready? Plant those feet. Ready and go. Extend up. Remember, you can squeeze holding at the top a little bit if you need to. Almost there. Give me four more. One more. All right. Take your time getting up. Whew, you guys are doing great. I love it. Nice work. We have this one more time. So let's give ourselves a second, and then we're gonna go ahead and get started. All right, I'm gonna do mine from the side again so you guys can see that form as well. Plant those feet, arms up, sit back, and go. Try and make sure you're sitting back with your weight, Andrew. Don't let those knees push forward. Good. Extend those arms up by your ears, really reach at the bottom. Let's go three more. Last one. Good. Go right into our downward facing dog. Plant those hands. Extend your leg. And tuck in. One more circuit to get through. And I'm not gonna lie, it's gonna be a little intense. We're gonna kick up the cardio just a little bit to finish it out, okay? All right, let's grab some water. Get mentally prepared for it. We're gonna have three exercises. The first is gonna be jump lunges. Jenny's gonna show you how to do this with just normal lunges if you need to take that modification. But Andrew and I are gonna show you the jump lunges. So you're gonna start in the lunge position, lunge down, and extend and explode up. Here, the most important thing is that you're landing softly. If you need to jump up and then lunge, that's another modification, okay? Whew, all right. Few more here. Two, one. Oh, they always get me. Shake those legs out. All right, we're gonna go into the high plank position and do Spider-Man. So I'm gonna turn to the side. Coming down, wrists in line with your shoulders. Extend elbow to knee. And go. Two more. All right, let's stand it up. Shake that off. The last one, get a little bit of a breather. It's gonna be warrior two, isometric hold. So I'm gonna turn to the side, you guys can see this. I'm gonna extend 1 foot forward, rotate the back leg, come out into a lunge position, extend your arms. All right, let's just hold this. Try and sink down. You're gonna feel your legs burn a little bit. Make sure that your knee and your ankle are in a line and that back leg is straight. Whew. All right, just hold this. Core is engaged, chest is upright. Try and really reach through those arms. Make this an active position. All right, we're gonna switch to the other side in two, one, go. So you're gonna bring it together. Take out that front leg if you need to. Send it over, and go. All right. Let's focus on our breathing here. Big inhale, exhale. Good. We're gonna go right back into our jump lunges after this. You guys ready? Okay, we're going in five, one. All right, let's come out of this one. Whew. Let's do it, all right? Get in that lunge position and go. Make sure both of your feet are pointed straight and your knees stay in line with your toes. Again, if you need to, jump up and then lunge back. Take any modification necessary. We want you to get the best workout you can. All right, switching to Spider-Man's in two, one. Let's shake that out. Give ourselves a second breather. Woo! Let's get down there and go for it. Wrists in line with shoulders, core is engaged, and go. Try and push with me on this one. I know it's hard, it's the end of the workout. Let's go, two more. One, two. Good job. Stand it back up. You guys ready to get into warrior two?
Yeah.
We're getting a little bit of a rest after this. We'll push to the side. Front leg is straight. Back foot is to the side and go. Try and extend into that lunge a little bit deeper. You might feel a stretch, or you just might feel all your leg muscles being really active, right? Good. Again, let's try and get our breathing back on this. So big rest in and out. All right, we're gonna switch to the other side in just a few seconds. All right, in two, one, switch. All right, woo. Get that other leg pointed straight, tilt that back foot, and go. So stay strong in this position. There's like a string pulling you up, and your arms are extending. Be really active in your whole body here. Big breath in, and a few more seconds. We're done in two, one. All right, bring those arms down, bring it together. Let's grab a sip of water. We have a little bit of a rest, and then we're gonna do all of that two more times. Stay with us. You can do it. All right. We're going to go back to those jump lunges. In 3, 2, and go. Me too. All right, let's hop down for Spider-Man. Go in 2, 1, knee to elbow. Warrior two. Extend your leg. Step that other one back. Sink down into that one. Reach out your arms. Good. Woo, this is a good workout. Take a second here and just realize all that your body's done up until this point and appreciate that because we're working hard. All right. Big breath in. Out. We're gonna switch to the other side, just a few seconds. Ready, in 2, 1, let's go. All right, send that other leg out. Get into that lunge, reach those arms. Good. We'll get a short rest after this, and then we have to do it one more time, and we get a nice cool down. Almost there. Focus on bringing that best breath back to normal. We're done in 3, 1. Bring those arms down. You know it's hard to keep them out there like that. Take a second rest. Let's go. Get pumped for our last round. You with me?
Yes.
Let's do it. All right, let's give it all we got. Last one. Jumping lunges in 3, 2, 1, go. Almost there. If you need to take a modification, do so, but don't quit on me. We're done in 2, 1. Shake that out. Let's get ready for our Spider-Man. All right, step it down to the ground. Plank position, and go. Knee to elbow. So 6 more. 2 more. All right, let's stand it up. Let's get into our warrior two hold. Extend one leg out. Get that other leg to the side. Arms up and go. All right. This is it, last thing. We get a nice cool down. Bring our heart rate back down. We're gonna switch in about 5 seconds. In 2, 1, other side. Extend that foot out. Core is engaged. Arms go out. Good. Try and get a little bit deeper into that Andrew Love. Last one. Good. Almost there. And we're done in about 10 seconds. Hold this for me. Core is engaged here. Active position. In 2, 1. All right, bring those arms down. Nice work. Good job. Let's grab some water, and we get a nice cool down. let's just come back to center. Feet about shoulder width apart. We're gonna just focus on our breaths right now. So we're gonna inhale, arms up. Exhale, bring your arms down. Really try and breathe deep. And exhale, good. Pick one. Make sure you stick with us on this cool down. It's a very important part of exercise. It allows your heart rate and body temperature to come back down after all that work you just did. And exhale, one more big breath for me. Inhale, and exhale, good. And then we're gonna do one more inhale, but on the exhale, we're gonna do a forward fold. So stay with me, inhale, exhale, we're coming forward, hinging at the hips. I'm gonna turn to the side so you guys can see my position. Let's just reach for the toes. Feel that stretch in your hamstrings. Try and release some of that tension. Good. We're still focusing on our breathing here. We're gonna place our hands beside our feet, step one leg back into a lunge, drop down, come up here, good. And we're gonna reach our arms up. Try and really push into this hip with your glute here. Extending, feeling that stretch. Let's inhale, exhale. Big one forward. All right, bring those arms down. We're gonna push back into that hip and extend your front leg here. This is gonna be a pretty deep hamstring stretch. So if you can't get your leg all the way straight, that's okay. And if you need to come more upright, you can do so. Wherever you are, that's all right. We're just trying to feel a stretch here. Good. Take a few big breaths with me. And on each exhale, try and just get a little bit deeper into the stretch. So inhale. Exhale, if you can, push just a little bit more. Inhale, exhale. All right, we're gonna come back to center and I'm gonna rotate again so you guys at home can see me. We're gonna stay in that lunged position. Bring your arm to the small of your back and we're gonna reach inside of that leg. So this is a shoulder stretch. If you can't do that, you can always just reach for that elbow here. Yep, and just keep a little bit of tension on it. So if you're able to, bring that elbow in, feel that stretch. You guys worked hard today. All right, we're gonna just gently release that. And we're gonna push back into downward dog. And we're gonna extend that leg that was just forward and push it through for pigeon. So that leg is gonna come perpendicular to the body. Good. Yep. So to make this stretch more intense, you can bring your shin more perpendicular to your body. If that's not where you are, just let it fall in a little bit. So feel the stretch wherever you are. Open up that chest. And again, if you want a little bit deeper, you can always fold your hips forward and reach over that front leg. Up to upright pigeon, plant those hands, and push back into downward facing dog. This time we're gonna extend the other leg and bring it forward for that lunged position. So step in between your hands and open up those hips. This is that first position on the other side. Reaching up, again try and push into this hip and deepen that stretch. Good. Big inhales here, and exhale. All right, you can bring those arms down. We're gonna push back and straighten out that leg for that hamstring stretch again. And if you're at home and have some blocks, you can always rest your hand on something if bending over this much is a little bit too intense of a stretch. You want to make sure you're stretching, but only just to the point of discomfort. We don't want you to push too hard and strain any of your muscles. All right, let's take one really big breath in. And exhale, just try and get a tiny bit deeper into that stretch. We're gonna push back, coming up slowly, placing that hand in the small of your back, and again, stretching out that shoulder. Try and keep your chest open here and upright. And we want our core to be engaged still for most of these stretches. They're a little bit more active. We're just relaxing what we're focusing on. So right now, just try and relax your shoulder and allow that body part to stretch. All right, you can always help yourself get out of this one a little bit, ease out of it. Place those hands beside your feet. We're gonna push back into downward facing dog and extend that same leg and come into pigeon on that one. Come forward. Open up that chest. Try and sink into the stretch. You can try and get your hips closer to the ground. Inhale, exhale. Come forward if you wanna deepen that stretch. Big breaths in, fill up your belly, and push out all of the air. Get into that stretch a little bit deeper. Just relax. Let's push up into upright pigeon. Plant those hands. We're gonna go back into downward facing dog. Gonna stay here a second. Let's walk the dog, so pedal those feet. Push in and stretch those calves. All right, and then when you're ready, let's just slowly walk those feet up towards your hands. Stay in this forward fold position. Grab your elbows with your hands. Sway side to side a little bit. Just release all of that tension. You worked so hard today. Appreciate all the work that you've done. Whew. All right, release that. And let's just roll up vertebrae by vertebrae until you're looking forward. Good. We're gonna get a few big shoulder rolls. So we're gonna come up and down. Up, down. One more, and down. Good job. Thanks for joining me today. You guys did great.